Welcome back after the break, guys. So let's get started with the next topic, that is insurance claim for loss of stock and loss of profit. This topic is segregated into two parts. One is the loss of stock wala problems or loss of stock policies, as we say. Another one is loss of profit policy. For maybe for the first few sessions, we'll be working on loss of stock policies first. Let's understand that fully. Then we will dive into the next section of the chapter, which is loss of profit. Okay. So for now, for today's session, discussion will be limited only to the loss of stock policy. Name itself is giving away a lot of things. Loss of stock. That means, obviously, we have lost some stock due to some accidents, could be theft, fire, earthquake, whatever, due to any natural calamities or anything, you have lost some stock. Okay, so normally we feel if there is a heavy manufacturing companies and all, most of them, they will take an insurance policy on the goods. Yes, anyone who is dealing with like jewelry business, jeweler, he stores so many jewels, correct? If some theft happens, means it will be a huge loss for him. Yes. So then generally what the jeweler will do? He'll take insurance policy on the jewels. So in case any mishap or any tragedy happens, that at least some money he'll be able to recover from the insurance company. Yes or no? So all we have to do in this particular topic is a particular business will be there due to some reason like fire, earthquake or whatever. They would have lost some stock. All we need to do is find out how much stock is lost. The value of the stock will not be given to you. We need to find that. One. Two, after you know the value of the stock, what is the next thing you will do? Approach insurance company and try to get the claim amount. Yes or no? So that is what we need to find. How much stock is lost? And second one, how much money we will get as insurance claim. That's all it is. Easy enough? Quite simple only, yes? Find out how much stock is lost and find out how much money we need to get from the insurance company. Fair enough. Good. So we have a couple of quick examples. We will run through them and then we'll dive into the problems. Okay, now. All right. First example we will take. This is without average clause. I'll tell you what does average clause mean. First, we will just look at the example and try to solve it orally there. Stock on the date of fire is 3 lakh rupees. On the day, a particular business, there is a fire. On that particular day on which the fire hit us, the stock value was how much, sir? How much we had? 3 lakh rupees. That means all that is going the goods salvaged from fire. Sir, if there is any fire, the goods will be burnt to ashes, or you can recover some goods from, you can recover some value from that goods. Possible that some goods could be half burnt, or they could have still some value. Possible. That only we call it as what? Salvage value. Very residual value. Yes. How much is the salvage value of the goods they have told, sir? 1,20,000. Don't read it further. Now, honestly, you think. On the day fire happened, we had goods worth 3 lakh rupees. That means, will we ask the insurance company to pay us 3 lakh? Or rather, even if you ask the insurance company to pay us 3 lakh, will they give us 3 lakh? No, what will they tell? Boss, I agree that the value of the goods destroyed is how much? 3 lakh. But goods are not completely destroyed. You are able to recover some money from that burnt goods or whatever. That is only salvage value. How much you are able to recover? 1,20,000 you are able to recover. Yes. That means in reality, what is the loss that the company has faced? 1,80,000. Yes or no? That means insurance company maximum will give only how much? 1,80,000. Because in your BCom or somewhere you could have heard, insurance is a contract of indemnity. Have you heard about this term? No, forgotten. Okay, what does that mean is you cannot profit from taking an insurance policy. If you are facing any loss, that loss you can recover from insurance company. You cannot make any profit from it. Is it okay? So like this is how it will work. Any confusion still here? Good. Okay. So actually in reality, your loss you faced is only 1,80,000. Let's read it further. find out the amount of the claim if the amount of policy. See, if you want to take get the insurance, means you have to take policy. That policy will have a value. Policy value. How much is the policy value? This is without average clause. Leave that for the time being. How much is the policy value you have taken, sir? 1 lakh rupees. Now you tell me, will they give you 1,80,000 as the loss? There's two cases they've given. Case one, case two. In the first case, you took policy for only for how much, sir? 1 lakh rupees. Will the insurance company give you entire 1,80,000 as a loss? Now what will they tell? Boss, you have taken a policy only for 1 lakh. Beyond the policy value, no insurance company will give you even 1 rupee more. That is the maximum claim in which they will settle. That means how much maximum claim you can get in the first case, sir? The maximum case you will get as amount of claim in the first case is only 1 lakh. Your loss may be 1,80,000, or it could be 1 crore 80 lakh also. Doesn't matter. Since your policy value is only 1 lakh, the claim will be restricted only to 1 lakh rupees. Are we fine? That is the first case. All these are bacha problems. They'll not come. Just to give you an idea about the things, I'm just discussing this with you. That's all. Can we get to the next one? In the second case, the insurance policy you have taken is 2 lakh rupees. This time you're smart enough. You have taken 2 lakh rupees. Now, can you tell insurance company, give me 2 lakh rupees? No. They will say, okay, give me the statement. What does the statement will say? Loss is only 1,80,000. So, insurance company will say, boss, I am not here to give profit to you. I am here only to cover your loss. Your loss is how much? 180. Okay. So, that means you'll only get 1,80,000. So, in simple term, it will be what? The loss amount or policy amount, whichever is lower, they will give. That's all. Done. Now, this is a simple example just illustrating how much money you can expect from the insurance company in these sort of cases. Need a minute, or can I get to the next example? Can I get to the next example? Or if you need a minute, I'll just give you some time. Don't need to write all this. This is just an overview we're discussing. That's all. Need time or move on? Online people also can tell. It's okay. I will not feel bad if you respond. Move forward. Okay. Then there is something known as average clause. Okay. Then there is something known as the average clause. How does the average clause works out? Let's see. We have a small example here. If stocks worth 5 lakh, this is 5, not S. If stocks worth 5 lakh is insured for 3 lakhs only. Worth of the stock is how much, sir? 5. But a company has taken insurance for only 3 lakh rupees. And the loss incurred due to fire is 2 lakh rupees. Loss incurred due to fire is how much? 2 lakh rupees. Claim will be how much? Don't look at the working. Okay, look at only 3 numbers. So, if you want, we can write it down here. Stock value is how much? Stock value is 5 lakhs. Alright. Policy value is how much? Or the insured value is only 3 lakhs. So, that means, have you taken the insurance for the correct amount, or have you underinsured it? Underinsurance means taking it lesser. Value of the stock is 5. That means, ideally, you should have taken insurance for how much? At least 5 lakh. But you took it for, to save insurance premium, you took it only for 3 lakh rupees. So that means this is a case of what? Under insurance. Is that okay? If you have taken for a insurance value for a lesser amount, we call that as an under insurance. In that case, no, there will be one thing that gets triggered, and that thing is known as average clause. In case of under insurance, one component will come in, that is what? Average clause. Now, how does this average clause work? There is a fancy formula for that, but without formula, we'll try to derive the formula logically through our own notes. Okay, sir. Stock value is this much, policy value you have taken is this much. Unfortunately, no. Some mishap, some tragedy happened. Did you lose any stock? Yes. The loss due to fire is how much? So, the loss of stock, can I tell? The loss of stock due to fire is how much? 2 lakh rupees. Now, you tell, when the insurance company give entire 2 lakhs, on the face of it, if you compare, what will you say? Sir, anyway, we have taken it for 3 lakhs, no sir. Loss is only 2 lakhs. Full amount they should give, no. Is what you are probably, your heart and your mind is probably saying to you. Yes, no. But insurance company, what will they tell? Hang on. I agree. All right. See, if you had taken the insurance for 5 lakh rupees, I would have given you full claim of 2 lakh rupees because you have taken the value of insurance correctly. So full loss, I will cover it for you. But in this case, did you take the insurance for the correct value or did you undershow it? You did an under insurance. Yes or no? That means what will they do? They will prorate the loss or proportionately reduce the loss. That is what we mean by applying average clause. Manageable. It's like you can do it like X method. Okay. Claim and value, you could say. If you had insured your stock for 5 lakh rupees, no? You would have got full claim of how much? 2 lakh rupees. If you had taken full insurance for 5 lakh rupees, you would have got full claim of 2 lakh rupees. But you know, to save money, you took insurance for how much? Only for 3 lakh. If you have taken insurance only for 3 lakh, how much claim will you get? That's all. This proration is what we refer to as average clause. Manageable now? Yes or no, sir? So X will be what now here? 2 lakh into 3 lakh divided by 5. So if you do that, whatever number you're going to get, that is, I think they've already calculated, that is 1.2 lakh rupees is what you're going to, if you calculate, you're going to get 1.2 lakhs. Fine, no? Done. For this, there is a fancy formula. Can I give you the formula for this? All of you? Or you can only construct the formula for this. What is this 2 lakh rupees, sir? What is this 2 lakh rupees? Loss of stock. Done. Or can I say loss of stock on the date of fire? On the date of fire, that much stock was there, which is lost. Okay. Into 3 lakh. What is this 3 lakh? Or loss of... we'll just write loss of stock. It's okay. Loss of stock. And what is this 3 lakh, sir? Policy value. Or you can also write it as insured value. Divided by what? 5 lakh. What is that 5 lakh? The total value of the closing stock for which you had to take the insurance. Or can I write simply like, you know, closing stock on the date of fire? Or the value of closing stock on the date of fire? Or there's also a few. Okay. So if you do this, no? In examination, you'll write this formula and then calculate and show the answer. But do we really need to mug up this formula or we can drive it on our own? In fact, we did not even know this formula. Correct? No. We used this and constructed our formula. Yes. Manageable. This will come in all of our problems. First, calculate the loss of stock. Then applying the average clause, finally get what? The claim amount. Final claim amount. Done now. Example is clear for everyone. Need a minute more? Don't worry, we have around at least probably what 10 or 15 problems or maybe more in this topic. Almost in every problem, this will come. You don't have to worry too much about this. This is the last fitting in almost every problem. Done. Aage bade. Okay, so question number. Sir, denominator, the last word is fire, right? Yeah, fire. Oh, it's looking like fixer. Okay. I will write it again. Date of fire. Og. Okay, first problem paklama. Okay, from the following information, ascertain the value of the stock on 31st March 20X2. You need to find out the value of stock. In fact, 1 minute, hang on. 1 minute, hang on. First problem. No, it's not a good problem. We'll put it on hold. It is very tough. I don't know it. Now, it is a specific type. What we'll do is, that here, no, there is various categories of problems. Study material has just combined it in random orders. Okay, so we will take up, there are 3-4 questions which belong to the same type. That we will do today. This belongs to another type of question. Like this, there are another 3 or 4 problems. All that we'll do it in one stretch, maybe in tomorrow's session. For now, let the first question be on hold. We'll do it tomorrow. Come to question number 1 minute. Let me look at question number 2. Oh, I written it. Yeah, I think we can start with question number 2 first. Mr. A prepares accounts on 30th September each year, but on 31st December 20X1, fire destroyed greater part of his stock. Most of his stock is down the drain, gone. Following information was collected from his book. Stock as on 1st October 2021. Sir, 1 minute, sir. The here, knowing key part is the date of fire is very important over here, or whatever is a natural calamity. What is the date of fire? 31st December 2021. Why? The date of fire is important because that is the date on which you need to find out the value of the stock. On this 31st December, how much is the stock is what we need to find in this particular problem. Hence, that becomes an important component in these problems. Okay, following information is collected. They have given stock only, but they have given stock on which dates? They have given on 1st October, but we require it on 31st December. Okay, why they have given that, we'll see later. Then they have given purchase. For what period to what period they have given purchase? October to December. October, November, December. For 3 months they have given purchases. Again, for the same 3 months they have given wages. Wages is a direct expense or indirect expense? Wages is DE as in direct expense. Sales also they have given from October to December. Why do you think they've given all this information from October to December for 3 months? Sir? Why do you think they gave this? Perfect. Sir, if you prepare, I'll just discussing this with you. Let's say you need to find out anyway closing stock now, sir. Which account can give you closing stock? Or how can you find out closing stock? Or to rephrase it, by preparing trading account, can I get closing stock? Yes. If you want to get trading closing stock with the help of trading account, other components you should know. Yes, sir. Opening stock you should know. Purchases you should know. Direct expense you should be available. Gross profit should be available. Sales should be available. Then you can get what? Closing stock as a balancing figure. Agreed? Huh? Yes. In this problem, if you prepare a trading account from October to December, only for 3 months, not for full year, only for 3 months. Okay, because we want stock as on which date? 31st December. If you prepare trading account only for 3 months, that is from 1st October to 31st December, only for 3 months, 1st October ka stock will be what, sir? Obviously opening stock, because your trading account you are preparing only from 1st October. So 1st October ka stock will become opening stock. October to December ka purchase you know, October to December ka direct expense you know, October to December ka sales also you know. One more thing, if you know, no closing stock, aram se you can find out. What is that? Gross profit. Yes, everyone, online people are also okay with this. Till here, whatever we're discussing, I'll put it up, but just whatever we had discussed, are we comfortable with that? Yes. Okay, the rate of gross profit is 33.33% on cost, or this you can just write it as 1/3 on cost. Because if you do 33.33% in your calculator, like 33.33 divided by 100, if you do in your calculator, you're going to get 0.33333333, like this you're going to get. Yes, sir. If you do 1 divided by 3 also in your calculator, you're going to get the same 0.3333. Agreed. If you want, you can test it also. Manageable. So GP is what, sir? They told GP is 1/3 on cost. But do you know the cost over here? When they say cost over here, no, what they mean is COGS. COGS. Here. Okay, whenever they say GP is this much on cost, huh? They're not here. Cost is cost of the goods sold, not just purchase. Don't apply it on purchase. Purchase is not the only cost. Even wages is a cost. Okay, so you should always apply it on what, sir? COGS. That is the cost here. Alright. Do you know COGS? No, because to know COGS, we require, how do you get COGS, sir? COGS is nothing but opening stock plus purchases plus direct expense minus closing stock. Do you know closing stock? No. If you don't know closing stock, can you find out COGS also? No. That means, can you apply this equation directly now? Not possible. That means, looks like we are stuck, everybody. Looks like we are getting stuck. How do we come out of this chakravyuha? Huh? Cut the problem. Huh? Yeah. Any thoughts on the online front? How do we sort out this issue? Somebody is saying, sir, simple, sir. What sort of question is this? Apply it on sales, they're saying. They have given GP on cost, no? Somebody is saying, apply it on sales. Okay. I'll apply it. What will I apply it? Can I apply it on 1/3 on sales? If GP is 1/3 on COGS, can I apply same 1/3 on sales? 1/4, not 2/3. Okay, somebody said 1 - 1/3. We did it as 2/3. No. Okay, let me do a thing. Maybe group 2 may we covered this. That's the reason people are answering. Okay, let's do one thing. Write this down in your notebook. There is a relationship between GP on, or maybe we'll write it like this. There is a relationship between GP on COGS with GP on sales. What is that equation is? If GP is half on COGS, if GP is 1/2, if you do in a calculator, you're going to get 0.5, or it could also be 50%. They could give it in fraction or they may give it in percentage, doesn't matter. But I always prefer to do it in fraction because it works a lot better. You will see. And this particular equation, we'll be using left, right, center. Okay, in many topic in group 1, like department, account, branch, many topics we'll be using this. Even in group 2 advanced accounting also, this equation will definitely be helpful. So do remember this properly. So if GP is half on COGS, or if it is 50% on COGS, then GP will be increase one number to the denominator. Half will become 2, will become 3. So it will be 1/3 on sales. So if it is half on COGS, it will be 1/3 on sales. Similarly, if GP, 1/3 means, or if you want to express in percentage, it will be 33.33%. If GP is 1/3 or 33.33% on COGS, then GP will be 3, will become 4. So it will become 1/4. 1/4, if you do in your calculator, you're going to get 0.25. That is nothing but 25%. Okay, so 1/3 on COGS will be 1/4 on sales, like that. Similarly, if GP is 1/4 or 25% on COGS, it will be 1/5 or 0.2, that is 20% on sales. All right, like this, if you go on dragging, if GP is 1/11 on COGS, it will be, if they give 1/11, then this will be 1. If it is 1/19, it will be 1/2. So on and so forth, the equation will move on. This equation will work out 100% no matter what. Okay, universally accepted equation this is. Manageable. Generally in examination, they give this. This is tested a lot often. This one. This or this one among these generally gets tested. Or you could say one among these three are beyond this, they don't take it. Generally, examiner's favorite is this. 1/4, 1/5 has been asked a lot of times. But one among those three, they will ask. Clear? Any problems? No problem. Okay. Somebody is saying, sir, should we have to mug it up? Okay, let's do one thing. Let's not mug it up. Let's prove that equation, whether it is working out or not. I think I did prove it to you when I did advanced accounting, I think.
Yes.
No problem. We'll just run it by again. Which equation you want me to prove? I'll prove one. You tell me which one. This is one. This is two. This is three. One only you want me to prove? Okay. So we'll take up the first one. Give me any number divisible by 3, sir. Preferably a smaller number. 20? 21 you want? Okay. I'm taking any number divisible by 3, okay? And the number I've got is how much? 21 it seems. Okay, I don't know how you got 21, but no bro. God bless him. But yeah, 21 it is. Or 2 plus. Aitha Sande. Okay. Sales is 21. Fine, sir. Sir, what does our equation say? The first equation we are proving. What does our equation say? GP is, or maybe let's do one thing. Okay, no problem. We started. No issues. Okay. Our equation says what, sir? GP is 1/3 on sales. What is our sales? 21. So that means the GP will be 1/3 of that, which will be how much, sir? 21 into 1/3, if you do, you're going to get obviously 7. Easy. Okay. Sir, if you know the sale value and if you know the profit, can you find out the cost? If you know sales and if you know profit, can you find out the cost, sir? What will be cost? Cost plus profit is your sales. Sales minus profit is your cost. Sales is 21. If the profit is 7, means the cost has to be what, sir? 14. 21 minus 7, which is 14. Okay. So let's test the equation. Let's do profit upon sales first. How much are we getting? Profit is 7. Sales is how much? 21. 7 threes are 21. So that means, can I say profit is 1/3 on sales? Okay. Let's test profit upon cost. When I say cost, I mean here what? COGS. Okay. So let's do profit upon COGS only, better. Profit is 7. Profit is 7. Cost is how much, sir? Just now we got 14. That means 7 twos are 14. That means, can I write it is half on COGS? That is what our equation is also telling. If the profit is 1/3 on sale, it has to be half on COGS. Like this, any random numbers you can assume and prove the equation. Okay. So if you feel like you're getting confused with the equation, assume some numbers and do it. Easy way to remember is what? Which alphabet comes first in English? C or S? C, right? So the first, always write COGS. Then write sales. And then go on increasing one number to the denominator. Half becomes 1/3. 1/3 becomes 1/4. 1/15 will become 1/16. Like that way you learn. That way also, if you want, you can remember. Clear? So the equation funda is okay now? Okay. Anyone wants to write down anything? Should have to wait or come back to the questions? This will be used in many chapters. If you need some processing time or writing time, I'll wait or I shall come back to the question. Online is telling, when will you end the class, sir? That is 9:15, Noda. You don't have to ask, given no. Okay. All right. So I think I can move forward now. Now, coming back to this, we did so much of drama now. Now you tell me, sir. GP is 33.33. That is nothing but 1/3 on cost. Cost means here, COGS. COGS, do you know or missing? Missing. But sales, do you know? Yes. So if a GP is 1/3 on cost, it has to be what? 1/4 on sales. Sales, do you know? Yes. So sales is 1,40,000, means into 1/4, if you do, you're going to get the GP. So opening stock, you know. Purchase, you know. Direct expenses, you know. Sales, you know. Through sales, you can find out GP also. So only thing missing is what? Closing stock. Prepare a simple trading account. You got the closing stock. Problem over. Yes or no? Can we start the solution? Huh? In fact, 1 minute. Hang on. They're saying stocks to the value of 3000 was salvaged. Let's do a thing. Let's put these information for the hold for the time being. Let's first find out the value of the stock destroyed on fire. So question number two, is it? Question number two ka solution we're putting. First, we are doing what, sir? What do we need to find out? Closing stock. How are we ascertaining closing stock? By preparing trading. Hang on. Are we preparing the actual trading account, or this is an account prepared to just get closing stock? Only for 3 months we are preparing the trading account. Yes. Hence, such a trading account, we call it as memorandum trading account. The word memorandum in accounts means rough work. This is not actual. This is just a rough work. Because we require closing stock. Hence, we like working note. Will you show working note in the financial statements, in the annual report? No. Working notes are only for what? Internal records. Same like that. Memorandum. You must have prepared memorandum revaluation account in your CA foundation or something. Yes? Same like that. Those of you who have come through CA foundation route, or even in plus 11th standard also, you had memorandum revaluation account. Okay, no problem. But the word memorandum in accounts means rough. Okay. So we are preparing here memorandum trading account for which period? We are preparing only for the 3 months. What is those 3 months here? From 1st October, for the period 1st October 20X1. 20X1 to 31st December 20X1. So we'll drop the trading account ka format. That is nothing but particulars, amount, particulars, amount. Okay, sir. First one. So we are preparing only from 1st October to 31st December. So 1st October ka stock will become opening stock. So do you know the opening stock? Yes, they've only given the opening stock. Check how much is the opening stock. 29,700. So you got opening stock. After opening stock, what comes? The purchases. Do you know purchases for these 3 months, October to December? Yes, it's given. Purchases is 75,000. Okay. Next, they have given the wages. Wages is a direct expense, so it will come in trading account, and the wages happens to be 30. Huh? Additional information, something is there. Oh, they have given. Oh, yo. Next page, mate, is there. Oh. Hang on, guys. He's saying additional information, may they have given some adjustment, it seems. It's given, huh? Okay, 1 minute. If it is given, no. What I will do is, I will use magic. You use whatever you want or whatever you can. Probably you'll use galis on me. Baddi magaanata. Okay, all right, come back. Come to the additional information. There is something in the adjustments they are telling. Yeah, I didn't read that. My bad. Stock at the beginning. Stock at the beginning means opening stock, no? Was calculated at 10% lesser than cost. Ayyo. So, is the value of the opening stock correct, sir? Or they've done some mistake? Unnecessarily, 10% value they have reduced. That means, can I say, how much is the opening stock given in the question, sir? 29,700. 10% they showed less, no? I mean, can I say 29,700 is the value for 90%? 10% lesser value they have shown. I mean, they are showing the stock only at 90%. But we want correct value. No? Correct value is how much? 100%. For 90%, if it is 29,700, for 100%, how much? You don't have to show this in examiner to the examiner. This is just for your reference. In your notebook, you can copy. Clear, no? So 29,700 is a stock representing 90, but we want stock at 100%. So into 100 divided by 90, if you do, you're going to get the value. How much is that? 33,000. That's all. Any confusion, anybody? These are simple problems. Any issues you have, please sort it now only. These are very basic problems that we'll be doing in today's session. Okay, I'm not hearing anything, so I'm thinking all of us are good with this. So, any other additional information they've given? Oh, yeah, actually, a couple of more are also there. A plant was installed by the firm's own worker. Plant and machinery is there, no? Maybe plant and machinery is pretty big. It requires some installation. We didn't hire outside a technician to install it. We told, we are conjuice people. What did we do? We got hold of our worker only. We told, hey, come here. You do the installation. Papa, he did. Okay. He was paid. But what did we do? We gave him money. That way we are generous. Maybe outside people, we had to pay 1,000 rupees. But our person, we paid probably lesser. Again, they don't know that. I am just assuming. Okay. He was paid how much? 500 rupees. So he was paid to install the machinery. You know, he was paid a wages of 500 rupees. This was included in the wages. They are telling us. Is it correct or incorrect? A machinery is installed. Okay. For that installation, no? One worker was brought in. There are some installation charges. How much installation charges we gave? 500 rupees we paid to him. That installation charges paid on the plant and machinery. That is fixed asset purchase, no? They included it in wages. Can we do this? Now, you have already learned. At least if you have not, we will learn more about this in accounting standard 10, property, plan and equipment. But you have done this in your 11th standard and all. This is a revenue expenditure or capital expenditure, correct? So any installation charges paid on fixed asset installation, what you should do? You should add it to the cost of the asset, meaning you should capitalize. Yes or no? You should add it to the cost of machinery. But our great accountant from the previous topic, that accountant again came here only. Okay. What did he do? He added it to wages. So is the wages amount shown correct or incorrect? He has added this. Can we add? No. He has already added. So what to do? Reduce it. So reduce how much? How much is his wages that he got? 500. So how much is the value of wages given in the problem, sir? Wages. Wages given is 33,000. 500 unnecessarily he included, but that 500 should have been added to the machinery cost. But by mistake, he added to wages. So hence we are working it out now, or we rectified his mistake. So the correct value of the wages is 32,500 rupees. Fair enough. Okay. Then purchases. Purchase include purchase of plant for 5,000. Sir, purchase sale means it is goods. Yes, no. Goods purchased, you will show it as purchases. Goods sold, you will show it as sales. Furniture purchased, building purchased, plant and machinery purchased, all that you will show it as purchases. Huh? No. Those are all what? Fixed assets. Yes, correct. For a machinery dealer, machinery will become a goods. That is okay. Have they told here he is a machinery dealer? No. That means, is this plant and machinery which he purchased 5,000, is it really a goods? Is it regular goods which we sell? No. Should it be included in purchase, or should it be shown in balance sheet as plant and machinery? It should be shown in balance sheet as a fixed asset. Yes, no? Correct. But our accountant, what did he do? He treated that as anyway purchase. No. Left, right, center, every purchase he has added off. Okay, so what should we do now? He has shown a purchase of 75,000 here. Is this the right amount of purchase? No. Plant purchase also is included over here. How much is the plant purchased value? 5,000. So that we have to exclude, because this is not the purchases. Okay, this is fixed asset purchase. You can't treat that as a normal purchase. So the purchase of goods is how much? Only 70,000. Manageable, everyone. Okay. Any other doubts? Okay, somebody is saying, sir, opening stock mein they told 10% opening stock is undervalued. So somebody is saying, sir, why don't we take 29,700 and straight away add 10%? You know, one question what we are getting, take 29,700. Just add 10% to that. No, sir, why are you doing so much of drama? Sir, okay, this is mathematics. You need to understand whatever was the correct value of the stock, no? From that they have reduced 10%. Not on this. After reducing, we have got 29,700. So you can't directly add to this. That will be mathematically wrong. Correct value of the closing stock is 33,000. From that, they have reduced 10%. You take 33,000, you do minus 10% in your calculator. Take 33,000 minus 10% you do. Obviously, you'll get how much? 29,700. That's how they have got 29,700. Now you take the same thing. 29,700 you take in your calculator. Add 10%. 29,700 you take, add 10%, you will 100% not get 33,000. Are you getting? No, that is mathematic issue. With plus and minus, there is a difference. Division and multiplication works that way. You can work front way also, you can work back way also. But plus and minus will not work like that. Okay? So you have to do it like this. Manageable. Good doubt. Good that you sorted this now only. I hope it sorted first. Is it sorted, sir? Or any doubt is there? You asked the doubt and he logged off. Okay, I'm thinking it is sorted. Okay, all right. Others, it is fine now. So that will not work out. Sir, how do we know if it is taken from main value? Sir, whatever value they've ascertained, 29,700, they only clearly told us, sir. It was shown at 10% lesser than cost clearly. It is mentioned over here. So what is the cost? Cost means the correct value of the cost only, correct? So correct value of the cost is how much, sir? Correct value of the cost is 33,000. That is the correct value of the cost. From that, they have reduced to 10%. Manageable? Like that, we need to identify. Clear, Devji? Now he's saying clear. Okay. No problem. You don't have to go so much into thing. You can do the same exercise. Whenever they say this adjustment, do it like this. Okay. Awesome. So this is done. Next, sir. Do we know sales, sir? Do we know sales? Yes, sales is how much, sir? Sales is 1,40,000. Is there any adjustment for sales, sir? No, not that. It is not visible to my eye. So probably not there. Sir, the moment you know sales, can you find out GP? Yeah, GP, they told us 33.33% on cost. Here, if GP is 33.33% on cost, it is nothing but one third on COGS. If it is one third on COGS, it will be one fourth on sales. If you don't like fraction, you can use percentage also. 33.33% on cost will be 25% on sales. Okay, but sometimes they may give you odd fractions. So it's always better to work with fractions. Okay, so sales is how much, sir? Sale value is 1,40,000. So 1,40,000 into 1/4 if you do, how much you going to get? Sorry, 35,000. That is your GP. Okay, so that looks like all the components we have got it. So what is the total? Can anyone tell? 170,500 is the total. Both the side, since it's an account, both the sides should match. But we are getting a balancing figure. Okay. This side is not matching. So only component remaining is closing stock. Closing stock we'll ascertain as a balancing figure. So 170,500 minus 1,40,000 if you do, you're going to get 30,500, which is the value of your closing stock arrived as balancing figure. That is what they have asked in the problem. That is one part of the equation. Can I get to it further? Loss scenario and all. They won't ask you in this case. If it is loss, put it on the other side. Still, the balance will match. They will not ask that equation. They will give profit only in this case. No, they will not play around with your sentiment so much. Okay, people will not attempt that problem only because their whole idea is being challenged. No, because they always learn GP is one third, one fourth, one fourth, one fourth. Suddenly, if you give loss, means pakka they will say, okay, this is gadbada problem. Let's not touch that only. Majority of them will skip. But yes, you will have to push it from debit side, push it onto credit side, and do the same thing. You will get the answer. So far, though, they have not asked. In your attempt, we don't know. If they ask you, let me know. And then the next attempt, I will solve. Okay. All right. Anybody copying anything or done? Done? Okay, that's all. Or we need to put up one insurance claim also. No? They also asked for the claim amount here, no? If you just check the question, the requirement is you are required to calculate the claim for the loss of stock. How much will insurance company give us? That we will do it in this format. This format we will repeat in all our future problems. Statement of claim we will write. And then write particulars amount. Okay, first one. So do you know the stock destroyed, value of the closing stock? Value of the stock, instead of closing stock, we'll just write stock. Value of the stock on the date of fire. Fire only happened here, no? Yeah. On the date of fire, what is the value of closing stock we got? 30,500. Entire 30,500 insurance company will give. They will first check if there is any salvage value. Yes, come to the problem now. Stock to the value of 3,000 was salvaged. Meaning you are able to recover how much? Though it is destroyed. Maybe it is some poor, some goods are not fully destroyed. There's still some value to it. And that value happens to be 3,000. So will insurance company give you 30,500 or what will they do? They will reduce it. So they will reduce something known as salvage value. This is given in the problem. And that is 3,000. So if you do this, you're going to get the value of the stock destroyed. Can I say? Value of the stock destroyed. How much is that? 27,500. Done, sir. Okay, will insurance company give you full value? No. If you have taken full policy, then they will give you full claim. If you have played around, if you have done nautanki, they will also do nautanki. Like, okay, first let's check. Have you done properly? Come back to the question. Have they told anything? Insurance policy was taken only for 25,000. So you are smart. You played around. So that means insurance company also will play around. So will average clause come into play here? No. Check. What is the value of stock on the date of hire, sir? 30,500. This is the value of stock, correct? That means how much insurance policy you should have taken? 30,500. But how much did you take? 25,000. So is it a case of under insurance? Stock value is 30,500. Insurance value is only 25,000. So there is a shortage. So it is a case of what? Under insurance. So in case of under insurance, what comes into play? Average clause. So last may you need to write net claim, or you can write claim amount as per what clause? As per average clause. You remember that formula? Can we present it as formula? If you want, you can, one more problem, you can present like this. We'll put up the dabba. What is that dabba? If you have taken insurance for 30,500, if you have taken insurance for 30,500, full claim value you would have got. How much is that? Entire 27,500, insurance company would have admitted the claim. They would have given you. Okay. If you had taken it for 30,500, but you played smart. You took it only for how much? 20? You took it only for 25,000. That means insurance company also will prorate like this. This is what you need to express in formula. Is it okay? Okay. What is this 27,500 or what is this 25,000? 25,000 is nothing but policy value. Yes, no? So the formula is policy value multiplied by 27,500, which is nothing but value of the stock destroyed. Divided by what? Divided by value of the stock on the date of fire. Divided by value of the stock on the date of fire. So that calculation will be simple like this. 27,500 into 25,000 divided by 30,500. So if you do this, what is the final value you're getting? Net claim is equal to 22,540. That's all. Thanks. This is all you need to present. Okay. That's pretty much for the first problem. Can the formula be substituted with dabba? It's not necessary that you have to write formula. So it is okay. It's fine. According to me, it's okay. But if you can remember it, it will be better, I feel. Why do you take a chance? In my opinion, even if you don't write the formula and directly calculate, you should get marks. But sometimes you don't know, sir. I am not correcting your paper. No. So they may deduct 1 mark also. Quite a possibility. You can take a chance or do what it is required. I'll leave that to you, sir. In my opinion, it should be okay. That's all I can say. Done, no? Can we get to the next problem? People are saying next problem also you will do. Oh yeah, we have 2 more problems to do. Now they're saying check. Don't worry, you have got the hang of it. No, that's all will come. But after 10 to 15 minutes, maybe we can finish and move on. Okay, question number three, sir. Let's do question number three. If you read this question number three. The class space is okay for the online students, right? No issues there, I believe. Yes, sir. Okay, no issues. Great. Unfortunately, Papa, they are wondering, can we increase it to 1.5 or can we increase it to 2 speed, sir? Live class, no, you cannot do that. Only recorded class students can do that, not you. Okay. All right. Question number three, it is on 20th October 20X1, the godown and the business premises of Aman Limited were affected by fire. So the date of fire or the date of destruction is 20th October. So we need to box that or we need to be aware of that. From the salvage accounting records, following information is available. Stock of goods at 10% lower than cost on 31st March 2021. I think by now you're comfortable with this. Is 2,16,000. But they have given stock on which date, sir? 31st March 2021. Sir, maybe year is, why have they given that is, maybe the year ends on 31st March 2021. The year will begin on which day, sir? 1st April. That means, can I say, this 31st March 2021 is for last year? Okay. Last year ka closing stock becomes current year ka opening stock. So that means, can I say opening stock on 1st April 20X1 given, not the correct value, given is 2,16,000. The value, that's what it is. Closing stock of last year becomes opening stock of the current year. So 1st April ka stock we know. Anyway, to get, you know, the funda, closing stock will be missing. Meaning we need to find out the stock as on which date? 20th October, because that is the date of fire, no? On the date of fire or on the date of that calamity, you need to find out how much stock we had that got destroyed. So this, on this particular day, 20th October, we need to find out the closing stock. So we need to find what here? Or we need to prepare trading account for what period? Last problem, it was 1st October to 31st December. In this problem, it will be? Give me the whole period. 1st April 20X1 to 20th October 20X1. So that is what, if you just check, they have given purchase and sales for. From 1st April to 20th October ka purchase and sales information they have given you there. That is for that. Okay. Opening stock on 1st April, it's already available. Purchase and sales information is also given. Fine. So let's run through the additional information now. Okay. Pay attention to this. Sales up to, or 1 minute, hang on, we'll maybe correct this off. 2,16,000, is it the correct value of the opening stock on 1st April 20X1 or incorrect value? They have shown it 10% lesser. Can I directly add 10% to 2,16,000? No, they reduced 10% on cost. So you can't straight away do that addition or minus. So you'll have to always go by that, the box approach. Okay, so that will be how much? 2,16,000 is, they've already reduced to 10%, no? That means it represents only 90%. 90% of the stock value is 2,16,000. For 100%, how much is it? So if you do that, it will be 2,40,000. That is your value of the closing stock. Directly, we'll show it within the trading account only. No need to prepare a separate working note for all this. Okay, now let's come to the other additional informations. First, sales up to 20th October, that is on the date of fire. Sales up to, meaning from 1st April to 20th October, that period ka sales ka, they've given something. Includes 80,000, sales for that period includes 80,000, for which goods had not been dispatched. So we have sold goods to somebody, okay, worth 80,000 rupees. Sorry, I forgot your name, what is that? Akash. Let's say I have sold goods to Akash worth 80,000. Fine. All right. I told him I will deliver the goods on 31st October. I told Akash I'll deliver the goods to you on 31st October. But unfortunately, my Kundli or Vastu is not good. On 20th October, Godown got destroyed. Okay. 20th October, Godown got destroyed. I already gave him the invoice. He told I want it. I told I already raised the invoice. He gave me the money or he didn't give the money. That's a different issue. Leave that. I already sold the goods to him. The sale invoice, I already gave it to him. If I've already generated the invoice, can I pass the journal entry for sales, sir? There is a conditions for this. We will learn more about this when I do accounting standard 9 revenue recognition. Okay, you'll learn more about this in Ind AS 115 and CA final also. Okay. Let's not go to CA final. AS 9 may, we will talk about some more criteria. For now, there are certain conditions. Since the invoice is already raised, can I pass the sales journal entry? Yes, I have already passed. That means this 80,000, I have already included in the 6,20,000. Okay, sir. Everyone okay till here? No problem. Now, goods got destroyed. I gave a call to Akash. Hey, macha, I have sold the goods to you. Invoice, I have already given it to you. But unfortunately, small thing happened. Goods gone. Forget it. Forget the goods. And he had paid the money also. He told, I'll keep the money. What do you think he will say? He'll come with porque. Yes or no? Brick, no? Brick, whatever he wants to get, he'll come and throw it. Yes or no? Correct? Will that be treated as a sale now? You tell me now. I might have generated the invoice. I might have booked it as sales. But will it be accepted by him now? No, because goods are gone. If goods are gone, what will Akash do? Yeah. Mafi. We'll end it. Okay, it is not a sale. Give my money back. Yes or no? Okay, everyone. So that means, is my sale really 6,20,000? Is my sale 6,20,000? No. My sale is only how much? 6,20,000. I've already included this 80,000 because they are only saying it includes. It's already included. So will it be treated as a sale? No. No. Hence, what do I need to do? Minus 80,000 I need to do. Comfortable. So that will be about 7,40,000. Oh, 5,40,000. 5,40,000 will be my sales. I'll put up the working of how to show it. I mean, if you just write this, that's good enough. But meaning, did we all of us understand? Give you a minute, since it's that Buddha's own time is coming. Okay, so I'll go a little slow. So I'll give you some extra processing time also. It is fine. I can understand. Okay. Purchase is up to 20th October. Same. For that period ka purchase. Somebody saying, sir, can you please explain again? Okay. 80,000, I have already included it in sales. I am not telling this, problem is telling. Since this goods are destroyed, no sir. Okay, it was there in my godown, but fire happened, so the goods got destroyed. So my buyer, in my example, my buyer is a Akash. So will he accept it? Will he accept it? You tell me, sir. Since you have a specific doubt, you give me yes or no. Will he accept it as a sale and pay me that money? No. So in reality, is this really a sale now? This 80,000 worth of goods, which I have already treated it as sale, okay, but I have not sent it. Will it be really treated as a sale? No, but I have already included it. Hence, what do I need to do? I need to exclude it. Hence, I need to reduce it. In reality, my sales will only be 5,40,000. That's what I meant. Okay, now, all right. Purchases up to October did not include. They're not saying includes. It did not include 40,000 for which purchases invoice had not been received from suppliers, though the goods have been received in godown. Okay, let's say Maruti. I purchased the goods from Maruti. Okay, worth how much? 40,000. Like a nice person, he gave the goods to me. So I took those goods and I'm storing that goods in my godown. Okay. Unfortunately, no, he did not give me the invoice. He told you take the delivery of the goods. I will give you the invoice later. Fine. I also said no problem. Since I did not receive the invoice, no, I did not pass journal entry for purchases. Because to pass the journal entry for purchase, we do it based on the invoice. You know? Since Maruti did not give me that purchase invoice, I did not pass journal entry for this purchase. Now goods are there where, sir?
Godown.
In my godown. Yes, specifically. Now my godown daga daga, meaning it's on fire, literally on fire. Yes. Okay, it's in on fire. Now I call up Maruti and tell, hey, you did not give invoice, noda. Your mistake, no. Yeah, I will not pay you the money. I am telling Maruti, you did not give invoice, I will not pay. Will he accept it? Now what will he tell? Goods once sold, sold. Okay, that's what he will tell. Correct. Okay, adela namu gottila, you have to make me the payment. Yes or no? I did not include it as a purchase, but in reality, what happens to this transaction? I have to treat it as purchase because I have to pay him. Yes or no? Okay, but what did our great accountant do? He did not receive invoice, so he did not pass purchase ka journal entry. So is this included in this 40,000? Did he include it in purchase? No. So that means, is this purchase correct? Is it really 2,80,000 for our calculation? No. It did not include what? 40,000. Now should I include it? Yes, because it's as good as my goods, no? Because I have to pay Maruti in this case, because it is my fault totally. Yes. So the purchase will be how much now? 2,80,000 plus 40, which will be 3,20,000. Getting the difference, why I deducted there, why am I adding here? It's just based on the logical inference. That's it. Okay. So that's about your purchases, sir. Okay, move on. Past records show GP percentage is 25%. Sir, have they told it is 25% on COGS or 25% on sales? Any reference like that? If there is no reference, we always take it as what? It is always on sales. So if GP is 25% means, can I say it is 1/4? Because in your calculator, if you do 1 by 4, you're going to get 0.25. 25% also, if you calculate, you're going to go get 0.25. If it is 1/4 on sale, sir, we will find out 1/3 on COGS. Our creativity better. Why? Anyway, we have sales. When you already have sales, why do you want to rework and go like this and all? Go straight. Okay? Sales is available means, aramse you can find out GP also. Okay? So, very, very straightforward problem. Salvage value they have given. Insurance value they have given. You need to find out the claim. Can we do it for effort? Okay. Anyway, we've discussed everything. Now we just have to put everything in. Or we have to express it in numbers. That's all. Homework. Bad. Huh? Bad. Okay. Nimappane, sir. Okay. Now I need to prepare memorandum trading account for what period to what period, sir? I need to prepare memorandum trading account from 1st April to 20th October. For the period 1st April to... Which question is this, sir? Where this question is? Okay, well, 1st April 20X1. What da? Ambrisha. To 20th October 20. 1st April to 20th October. Alright. First one. First, we require what, sir? Opening stock. The value of opening stock they have given is 2,16,000. Have they shown it correctly? No. They showed it at 90%. But we want, because they showed 10% lesser, no? So they showed it at 90%. We want to show it at correct value, which is 100%. So into 100 divided by 90, if you do. In fact, you've already done and told me that is 2,40,000 is the value of opening stock. Next, purchases is there. What is the value of purchases they told? 2,80,000. Can I treat it as 2,80,000 now? One purchase worth 40,000 we did not include, but the goods are already in our godown, so it has to be considered as a purchase, because otherwise that vendor will not agree. So the purchase will be 3,20,000 is the value of purchases that I need to show here. All right. Do we have any direct expense like wages, etc., etc.? Not given. If it is not given, take it as zero. On the other side, we have sales. The value of the sales they have given is 6,20,000. Okay, but can I treat it as 6,20,000 or I should need to reduce something? How much I know? What do I need to reduce? This 80,000 worth of sales. These goods, no, I had already given invoice, but I had not sent the goods. Those 80,000 are still there in my godown. Hence, the buyer will say those goods are already destroyed, so I cannot pay for it. So in reality, it will not be sale. But our accountant has already booked it as sale, because in the problem they're saying it is included. Hence, we are excluding. So this is 5,40,000. 5,40,000 is the sale value. So the moment you know sales, what can you find out? Gross profit. So GP. So the GP sale value is how much, sir? Final value you should take. The sales. What is the correct value of sales? 5,40,000. And the GP percentage is how much, sir? 25%. They only told 25%, so it is 25% on sales, on the correct value of sale, which is 540. 5,40,000 into 25%, if you do, you're going to get 1,35,000. There is no direct expense. That means you can get aram se what? Closing stock as the balancing figure. So 240 plus 320, 720, 720 plus 135 is 855. This side, 695. Okay, 6,95,000. So here also it should be 6,95,000. What is 1,155,000 is the value of closing stock, which is destroyed by fire, or that is the value of the stock on the date of fire. Now, simple claim statement, if we put it up, solution is over. Understood? Okay. Can I put up statement of claim? Statement of claim. Particulars amount. First, what do we require? First, we require value of stock on the date of fire. On the date of fire, we had a stock worth 1,55,000. Do we have any salvage value that they told? Yes, here they've given salvage value is 31,000. So we need to deduct the salvage value. So the salvage value given in the problem is 31,000. So stock destroyed is, value of stock destroyed, 1,24,000. So that is the value of the stock destroyed. Is there any average clause over here? We took the policy for 1,00,000 rupees. How much is the value of the stock on the date of fire? On the date of fire, stock value was 1,55,000. But we did conjuicy and we took insurance only for 1,00,000. So that means there is a clear case of what? Under insurance. If there is under insurance, average clause will come into play. So the last pointer is net claim as per average clause. That is given by how much? Which is equal to? How do we need to find out? That is nothing but policy value or insured value into value of stock destroyed. Perfect. Divided by value of the stock on the date of fire. If you forget the formula, use that box approach and derive your own formula. Value of stock on the date of fire. Again, you want me to show means, I'll show you the Dabba approach again. If you had taken insurance for full value, that is 1,55,000, that is actual value of the stock on the date of fire, then full claim of 1,24,000, you would have got from insurance company. But you took the policy only for 1,00,000. If you have taken policy only for 1,00,000, then how much claim will you get is what the formula is trying to calculate. So that will be 1,00,000 into 1,24,000 divided by 1,55,000. If you do this, you're going to get the net claim to be 80,000. That's all is the net claim ka final answer. Even if nothing is mentioned about average clause, but there will be underestimate insurance. Yes, apply it. Apply the average clause. If there is no average clause, clearly they'll mention. Okay. So compute the claim like this only in all the cases. So we will go for the question number four. We will do. Okay. All right. On 12th June, actually, there's a homework problem. Just for one adjustment, I'm doing it. If you want, fada for 2 minutes, we can run through a solution also and finish it. There is no new adjustment. Anyway, if you have understood the first two problems, then this should be a cakewalk according to me. Let's see now, actually, whether you are actually in the zone or in Buddha zone, we'll get to. On 12th June 2002, a fire occurred in the premises of N.R. Patel, a paper merchant. So that's your date of fire. Papa, paper, no? So full gone. Most of the stocks were destroyed. Salvage value is 11,200. Some salvage value you're still able to recover. What should we do for salvage value? In the statement of claim, deduct it. Okay. In addition, some stock was salvaged in a damaged condition and its value was agreed to be 10,500. Some stock may be full gone, okay, which you can recover only 11,200. Some other stock, they're just giving a degree of damage. Maybe one is 80% destroyed, one is 90% destroyed, or 40% destroyed, or whatever. One stock ka value is 11,200. Another stock ka damage condition value is 10,500. Now you tell me, what will you take it as a salvage value?
Both.
Perfect. Both. That's all. See, salvage value is a what value you can recover. Can you recover 11,200? Yes. Can you recover 10,500? Yes. So both are salvage value. That's all. Only because of that I took this problem. Other than that, there is nothing. Is it okay? Salvage value is just you need to add up these two and that becomes your salvage value. Online folks, clear off? So the salvage value will be 21,700 rupees in this particular case. Need a minute or forward march? Forward march out of the class, they're telling. Okay, we'll finish and then we'll go. Okay, from the books of accounts, following particulars are available. His stock at the close of account on 1st December, or his stock at the close of account on 31st December 2001, they have given, sir. Check the first line ka first date, sir. What is it? 12th June 2002. So current year is 2002. They have given 31st December 2001 ka. X1 is what? Current year or last year? Here they have given 31st December means here are we following April to March wala year or Jan to December wala year? Jan to December. So can I say this is last year ka closing stock? Which becomes current year ka opening stock? Can we directly look through as a solution? Okay. So, in fact, they have not done it. They didn't do it as trading account. They prepared it as a statement. No problem. Can we put up a simple trading account without format, nothing, just directly? 2 minutes. That'd be okay. Opening stock is how much, sir? 83,500. In fact, is it trading account or is it M trading account? M means memorandum, meaning rough trading account. This is done only to get the closing stock on the date of fire. Okay, so OS as an opening stock is 83,500. His purchase from 1st January, that is the start date of the current year, till 12th June 2002. Why 12th June? Because that is the date of fire. So from 1st January till 12th June, they have given the purchase. How much is purchase? 1,12,000. Check the additional information. Have they given any adjustments, sir? No, that means what, sir? This is very straightforward. No adjustment means everything is correct. So they have given correct purchase. How much is correct purchase? 1,12,000. 1 minute. Suppose they have given purchase return. Reduce. You should always take like the way you prepare trading account only, you should prepare. Okay. Any purchase return, if it is there, reduce it. Sales return, if it is there, reduce it. If it is already reduced, good for you. Ignore. Don't do double deductions. Okay. All right, so purchase is how much? 1,12,000. They have only given no adjustments. Then sales during the same period is 1,54,000. I don't see any adjustment for sales also. So directly we can write by sales how much? 1,54,000. on the basis of his accounts for the past 3 years, it appears that he earns on an average a GP of 30% on sales. It can't get simpler than this. Sales is directly given to you. GP is 30% on sales only. At least COGS, if that given, we could have done some conversion at least. So here GP is direct. How much is GP? 30% on sales, and the sale value is 1,54,000. So if you do that, 46,200. Any other adjustment is there? No, that means you will get closing stock as a balancing figure. How much is that? 2 lakh. Here it's saying 87,700. You're saying something else. Oh, you're telling me the total. Okay. I know, I directly tell me closing stock. It's 87,700 rupees is the value of closing stock. You prepare it as trading account. No need to prepare it as a statement. You can prepare it any which way. But we have done this trading account since our 11th standard day. So I think we are more comfortable with working it out as an account format. If you feel no, I'm equally comfortable with the statement format, present it. These are working notes, guys. You present it as a statement, you present it as an account, or you present it in your own fashion, it is okay. As long as you are able to understand it, one. As long as examiner is able to understand, two. You'll get marks. Okay? Alright. So that is done. Next is what? Statement of claim. Run through. Okay? That also they prepared differently. Yeah? No, here I think they've given. So okay, value. This only they prepared as here. Only they prepared statement of claim. Value of the stock destroyed is 87,700. What is the salvage value? Only one or two, or a combination of two here, which we already done. When we add these two, you're going to get 21,700. That's what they have taken it as salvage value. If you do that, you're going to get the loss of stock or the value of the stock destroyed. Apply average clause and get that. That will work it out. Policy value anyway given here. That I think that finishing touch you can give. That's all. Problem over. Very, very simple problems. Do not expect these sort of things in examination. 100% it will not come. If it comes, you should have such a big smile that, like, you know, your face only should fall off. Okay, that 99% doubtful. At least 2-3 adjustments will come. 1 minute. So still it is there. Question number 12, you know, is homework. Question number 12, it is similar to the questions we have done in the today's session. So take a question number 12 as homework for today. Just going through is fine. Hardly any adjustment is there in that also. Similar to this one. Okay. So that's it for today's session. Thank you.